say, thank y'all for coming. Everything we're doing this year is just, you know, to get that first experience of doing stuff bands do. And so this is our first concert, and as time goes by, it'll probably change a little bit more formal. But right now, we're just kind of going to give you a demonstration of the things that we've been doing so far this year. Our beginners couldn't be here because all of them, except, well, over half of them, were all quarantined in fifth and sixth grade. The kids were in the band. And so they couldn't be here. And so we will do them later. If we can't find a day to schedule them, maybe they can be at our February concert, and then you'll get to hear them. What we're going to do, because we already printed the programs, we're going to go ahead and just play their songs. And because technically these guys have been back in the fifth and sixth grade, these are some of the very songs they've played. So they're going to just play all these songs for you, and then we'll kind of move into the things that we were, specifically for us. So the first song we're going to play is Hot Cross Buns. Pretty quickly, they have to play other rhythms than what you hear them playing. This is London Bridge. Try to get them to do any extra stuff, and you know, they're moving right along, you know, at a pace that's normal. These guys, because there's older kids, they were kind of catching on to things quicker, so that's why we decided, hey, we're going to do this pep rally, virtual pep rally, and it's like, well, we might could just play some games. So that's why we kind of hit the fast forward button a little bit to let them be able to play some extra songs there. But technically, they're working in the same book as the beginners. They're just ahead of where they are, where the beginners are. But really, you know, we're all beginners working through a method that takes us through everything we need to know, every note, every rhythm, all that stuff. And having said that, then we're going to play songs that are kind of harder a lot. This next one is William Tell, which you might know as the Lone Ranger. So this is William Tell, and now we're kind of on our operator. So we're going to do this one for you as a round. Thank you. that's kind of stressful because, that's part of learning. First I start you off, everybody's doing the same thing, and then suddenly we're not all doing the same thing. And that's what it is. We're going to do a couple that are sort of new stuff in a way, what we call an arrangement, where they're not all playing the same part. This one is called Star Wars. So this is the main theme from Star Wars that you might recognize. And so we're going to do that for you next. So, thank you. We in order to do some of these harder songs, we just had to say, okay, we didn't get this in the book yet, but here's how you play this note, and here's how this rhythm would go, you know. And so that's why, you know, more pressure has been put on them, but I just still think that we're going to be better off for it to do it that way. Okay, so now our next songs are our pep song selection. So we're going to do, if you came to the games, then you probably heard us play some of these up in the bleachers, up in the stands. But we're going to do these, we're going to do not every one of them, but a bunch of them. We're going to do those. They're very short, and so we're going to play all these parts. In the game, you just get excited and, you know, you're trying to play real quick. But here, you sit down and look at the music and you know about all of that. So, we're going to play this pep song. First one we're going to do is We Will Rock. We Will Rock.
Thank you.
backup song selection, that's okay. It is customary to clap on the song, so I just need those others to just kind of sort. Okay, so I'm sure kind of said a lot of things I didn't even say here. Just a few things about our drum coming together. Just kind of tell you where we are with all this. It's really good to get a concert done because you work on these songs and I told them, so we play these so many times, but they only hear it the one time. That's just the way it is. So we're glad to move on and start doing some other things. But one thing we're going to do is the parade. We're going to be in the parade and at the Christmas parade here. So that's on the 12th. So I will send this as a remind, but they know we're going to practice. And it's already been sent out in a couple of different ways, but we're going to practice the Monday we come back after the e-learning remote week. After Thanksgiving, that remote week comes up, then that next Monday, we're going to stay after school till 5 and practice getting ready for the parade. And then that parade is that Saturday on the 12th. I believe it starts at 6, and so they're going to have to be here at 6. Is that correct, Ms. Jones? Six, okay. So they're going to be here at 5, so we'll kind of be ready for that. And then they'll wear their t-shirt and jeans. If it's really cold, they can wear jackets. We're not going to freeze them out. But I said if it's not very cold, they can just wear a kind of easy and just wear some long sleeve shirt under a t-shirt. And they wear Santa hats, we'll give them a Santa hat. And we're gonna play Jingle Whips, all right? And so that's what we're working on. Let me say about the marching, they're doing very well on learning how to march. And they're doing very well playing like just a whole note, and the drums are playing the cadence, and they're marching. But the biggest thing is they've got to be able to play Jingle Whips while they're marching. So I told them they need to practice at home, in their yard or in their driveway or whatever, moving while they're playing Jingle Bells. So first they've got to memorize it, and then they need to actually move around and do that. Because as far as just marching, they can do that. As far as just playing one solid note, they can do it while they're marching. But now it all gets more complicated. So anyway, we're going to do that. And it's going to be a stretch for us, but I think that's going to really be a good thing for us to do for the future. We try to send out a newsletter, maybe not every month, but every other month. So I'll try to get one out in December that kind of gives an update of all the stuff. We just send that home, and they're supposed to bring it home. I don't know if they do, but all we can do is give it to them. And then the next time we'll have a concert will be in February. But again, I'm very glad they're doing this. We had to start somewhere, and we started back in the summer with just a few of them, and then we gained some people, and we gained more, a lot of people, we just can't all be here. But we need to gain more. Okay, so we're always looking. There's no cutoff on when you can start band this year. Start from where we can get you. But we want to grow because, since they could show that they could go to Auburn and play up in the stands for a football game, well, then I think they could probably do a halftime show. And so I think that this summer we'll have a band camp. We'll learn maybe not a full, complete show, but best we can. And so, because I think that that's the goal, right? And so we want to get that going. I think that's about all we need. If you have any questions, you can always text me or message me or call me. I'm glad to always answer your questions. It's nothing to do about doing that. And then another thing I would ask is if you'd like to make a little walk tonight on the sidewalk, we would welcome anybody who would like to take a chair or stand back down to the venue, because we got to get all this stuff out of here. And they brought it up here, but they brought it during the day. They didn't have a home to the venue, so it's hard for me to get all of that. So if anybody wants to help us, we've got to get this stuff down. But I told them, the life of the band kid is a two-trip thing at concerts, because you take things back to your band room, but then you got to go back and get something else. And as you get bigger, you're going to grow, you're going to have a lot more passion. Anyway, so they just got to learn the two-trip method, but if you like to help, I would support that. All right, so the last thing we're going to do, though, and we're going to do it just kind of like we do the parade. The drums are going to play the cadence because they use some of the marching equipment that we've got down there. We kind of created the cadence. But they're going to play the roll-off. So they're going to go just a roll-off. So they're just going to go roll-off, and they're going to play jingle. And we're going to play it, it's going to be a little faster and a little bit more rhythmic than what the beginners would have played for. That's why I said we'll kind of save it for last. Technically, this isn't a Christmas concert. Next year, I'm not sure what we'll do, whether it'll be a fall concert or it'll be a sort of Christmas concert. Because, during the fall, we won't have time to, we'll be more fan of football games. I know it's not quite Christmas. I know Walmart's got all their stuff out. I know all that. But and I'm one of those people that got not listening to Christmas music until it's Christmas, but here we are, it's cold outside, and it's not gonna be that way, so we're gonna do Jingle Bells. Thank y'all for coming. Dr. Brown, anything?
I think we're good.